Hi, my name's Sophie. I'm one of the event managers here at Dine at Allerton Castle, and I'd like to show you around. Well, the castle itself dates back to the 17th century when it was first built and owned by the Stourton family, Segrave and Mowbray. It's had various uses over the years. It was used in World War II as a Canadian Air Force base and then was bought 26 years ago by the current owner, who has restored it to its former glory from when it was first built. There's been a lot of restoration work gone into the castle, and they take the most incredible care over every room throughout and in between each wedding and event that we do as well. So really lends itself to lots of different kinds of weddings. We've had a lot of themed weddings. There's a very gothic side to the castle, but also that lends itself to the medieval as well. So we've got an upcoming wedding in October who are having 10-foot wizards outside during their drinks reception. But a lot of traditional as well. We did a wedding a few weeks ago who went very traditional. They had a Scottish and Irish theme to the wedding, but quite nice in Yorkshire, where it all began for them both, where they first met. And they kept a very traditional theme. We had a piper who piped them down the staircase for their entrance to their guests. And then later on, the ballroom was all set with cut crystal glassware for them. Looked absolutely stunning and really reflected in the light in the ballroom there as well. We do about 80 weddings a year here at the castle. And they really range from sort of slightly smaller weddings, between 60 and 80, up to 120, which is the biggest wedding that we can do. And really for a range of budgets, and there's just so many different things here at the castle, so many different rooms. You can go for a really intimate Christmas winter wedding with the Christmas tree all lit up and really beautiful colours throughout the castle, into the really summer weddings. We've got beautiful grounds out at the back, just absolutely stunning for a drinks reception in the summer, pins out on the terrace there. And then into the ballroom, which is just absolutely stunning as well. This is the ballroom, and this is where we hold the wedding breakfast for the meal. Absolutely stunning room, full of natural daylight in here. Huge big bay window in front of me, and then two windows to either side. So really keeps a light, bright feeling in here. So we're set up for the wedding that we've got tomorrow, for 80 guests tomorrow, traditionally with the long top table that we do in front of the fire so that the bride and groom get the beautiful views out of the bay window in front of us. So they've gone for quite a traditional menu tomorrow, starting off with a French onion soup for starter. We've then got the classic lemon salt roasted chicken for main course afterwards, and then followed by a gorgeous Madagascan vanilla creme brulee afterwards. I work for Dine, and that's the company that do all of the catering here. It's all in-house. There's myself and my colleague who work for Dine, who are based here permanently. And we do everything from the initial show rounds and then running the wedding itself on the day. So two fantastic chefs also based here at the castle, and they're really fantastic with a wide variety from the menus that are shown in the brochures to sort of traditional family favourites as well. We get a lot of people who sort of say, oh, we quite fancy sort of an afternoon tea style canapés for the wedding to complement something like Pim's out on the terrace in the summer, but then maybe want to come in and have sausage and mash for the main course. Then at the same time, we can go that little bit higher. We've got a fantastic wedding coming up in September who really want the best for all of their guests. So we've got Michelin experienced chefs here at the castle. So they're really creating a menu for what they want. So this would be the bride's entrance for the ceremony. Absolutely fantastic. And if you can imagine, this is the first time that your guests get to stand up, turn around and see you walking down the stairs in your dress. Looks absolutely beautiful, and just nothing like it nearby either. Beautiful, beautiful room here for the ceremony. Naturally decorated with the oak panelling. We've got the rosewood elephant behind me and a beautiful fireplace that's lit all year round. So many different things that you can do with flowers here in the Great Hall as well. We've got pew ends and the staircase decorated today with a beautiful arrangements at the front there as well. We can seat up to 120 guests here in the Great Hall for the ceremony. And it's a beautiful room, almost quite church-like in itself for those who want to have the civil ceremony without the religious aspect. Just looks absolutely stunning when it's all set up in here. So then your drinks reception either in the Great Hall again or outside on the terrace and in the memorial gardens. And then we would go through to the ballroom for dinner. And then your dancing again would take place in the Great Hall for the evening. and then various different rooms as well, from the billiard room for the groom's party before the ceremony, so they can have a game of billiards beforehand. And then the drawing room where we are now, which we use to do the signing of the register, makes for beautiful photographs. So this is the drawing room, and this is the room that we traditionally use when you're having a civil ceremony to do the signing of the register. So once you'd said your vows in front of your guests, we would come through into here with your new husband, the parents, bridal party, and those who you wanted in here. We use the table in the centre here to do the signing of the register, and just makes for some absolutely beautiful photographs in here. And then again throughout your drinks reception later on, after the signing and after the ceremony, to come back in again for photographs and to show it off to people as well. From photographs in front of the fireplace to posing on the furniture, just looks absolutely stunning in here and really makes for those special photographs. We've got three bedrooms here at the castle. We've got a beautiful bridal suite full of gold leaf furniture, huge big wardrobes, an amazing bed, his and hers bathrooms in there as well, with beautiful views out over the lake in the background and over the grounds and terraces. This is the bridal suite. Fantastic for the bride to get ready in before the ceremony, with all the bridesmaids having a celebratory glass of champagne before the wedding. Beautiful photos again in here, reflections in the wardrobe as well. And for the night, a fabulous bed there in the background. Absolutely gorgeous to spend your first night in together. The venue works so well, so many different photo opportunities. It's exclusive for the couple who get married here, so you've got nobody else around on the day. You, your family, your friends, so many different places to go, and so adaptable as well to how they want it, and whether they want to go all out and keep in the theme of the castle, or to keep it quite simple and let the castle speak for itself.